over the years, I've talked a lot about how much money I make on Turo. I've talked about how much my fleet makes, how much my best performing cars make, how much my most expensive cars make, what cars have the best ROI. I feel like I've talked about it all. But the one thing I haven't talked about is how much my oldest car makes and simultaneously my worst performing car, because they're the same car. So in this video, I'm gonna be breaking down how much my oldest and worst performing car makes since it's been on the Turo platform. Now, I'm gonna warn you, it's probably more than you think, and it also has a much better ROI than you'd think as well. So let's get started. Now, before we dive in, I would like to note that I am currently sick. I'm getting over a severe cold that my 9-month-old niece gave me.
I can't go out. I'm sick.
Now, I'm gonna be honest, I actually didn't realize that babies could get adult sick. I feel like maybe if I sat down and thought about it, I would have realized that that was possible, but that's something that's never crossed my mind. So as a result, whenever I was babysitting my sick niece last week, I didn't take any regard to my own safety, and as a result, I got the exact same cold that she had. So I've been sick now for about 7 days. I'm slowly but surely getting over it, but I wanna offer you the forewarning ahead of time. And of course, while we're at it, if you guys could do me a huge favor, if you could hit the like button and hit the notification bell for the YouTube algorithm. This helps my channel grow. It helps let YouTube know that you guys are enjoying my content, and thus they push my content out to a new audience. So if you guys could do that, I would greatly appreciate it. Now, like I mentioned in the intro, on this YouTube channel, I've talked a bunch about my different cars and how much they've made, but I've never talked about my worst performing car, which is also my oldest car, and that is my 2007 Red Ford Focus. Now, my 2007 Red Ford Focus is not only my oldest car I own, it's also my worst performing car. It's also my cheapest car as well. Now, whenever I say that this is the oldest car I own, what I mean by that is it isn't my only 2007. In fact, I have a 2007 Toyota Yaris listed on the platform as well. What I mean by oldest is this is the car that I've had on the Turo platform the longest. Now, I owned cars before I owned this Ford Focus, but those cars have either been sold or wrecked. So as we sit here today, this is my oldest running car on the Turo platform, and it's been on Turo for 2.5 years. It's also a 2007 year model, which means it's one of the older cars on just Turo in general, because Turo has a 12-year rolling year model requirement, which basically means that you can't list a car that is over 12 years old. Once that car becomes older than 12 years, that car is no longer eligible to list. Now, because of the fact that I listed my 2007 whenever it was eligible to be listed on Turo, and I've been able to keep it on Turo without it having any maintenance issues, I've been able to keep it as an active and listed vehicle. So basically, the rule of thumb here is that you have to list a car that is 12 years old or newer, but once it's listed, it can stay on the platform as long as it's safe and reliable. But not only is this car my oldest and my worst performing, it's also my cheapest car I've ever purchased. I bought this car for $2,300 back in 2019. So now let's dig into the numbers, and after we dive into the numbers, I'm gonna give you guys some context as to why I think this car has performed the way that it has. Now, in 2019, this car was only listed for a portion of the year, and once all things were said and done, this car had a profit of $2,213. Then we fast forward to 2020, which was a weird year for many Turo hosts. 2020 was slow because the first half of the year was like basically dead. I remember I had no cars out for basically the entire month of April, and March and May were also slow. So as a result, the 2020 earnings were not very good, and they came in very similar to what 2019 was. In 2020, this car made $2,617. Then in 2020, without November or December being taken into account, this car has made $4,307 in profit, bringing the grand total to $9,107. $73. I would like to take into account that this is after all expenses have been paid. This is our take-home pay from this vehicle, but not including the purchase price of the car. Now, whenever we look at the number $9,173, especially in the context of being earned over the course of 2.5 years, it may not sound very good, but the reality is I'm actually pretty happy with this number, and there's a few different reasons why. Number one is the Ford Focus is a pretty reliable car. It hasn't had a ton of issues. There were some things that we had to do to the vehicle right after we bought it because of the fact we got it for such a dirt cheap price, but over the years it has been super reliable. The only things that it's needed here and there are some motor mount replacements, which HP can do for $50 and in about an hour's worth of time. The other reason why I'm happy with this number is because of the fact that this car was dirt cheap. It was $2,300 to buy, and whenever we look at the amount of money that this car has earned versus the amount that it cost to buy, there's an ROI of 300%. So though just over $9,000 isn't Lamborghini money, and it certainly isn't break the bank, bank money, it is a very consistent, very well-performing car whenever we look at it from an ROI perspective. So we talked about the amount of money that this car makes. We also talked about why I'm happy with that number. Now let's talk about why this car isn't performing as well as my other cars. Well, number one is the year. It is a 2007 and it looks like an old car whenever you look at it. I have a 2007 Toyota Yaris that performs significantly better than this 2007 Ford Focus. And the reason why is because this 2007 Ford Focus was the last year model with this body style. So whenever we go up even one year model to a 2008 Ford Focus, the car looks dramatically newer. On the flip side, if we look at the Toyota Yaris did not change body styles until 2011. So if you look at a 2007, 2008, 2009, and a 2010 Toyota Yaris, they all look the exact same. This has really helped my 2007 Toyota Yaris to earn the same amount of money as it would have earned if it was a 2010 year model. The other reason why this car hasn't performed as well as some of my others is because of the fact that people use this car to get from point A to point B, and that is basically it. Now, whenever it comes to Turo, there are a lot of different ways to make money. Your daily trip price is one of these ways, but you can also make money off of convenience fees. You can make money off of cleaning fees, smoking fees, damage claims. There are a lot of different ways to make money with your Turo fleet. And whenever it comes to this Focus, I feel like I've never made money off of any other way but the daily trip price. Now, don't get me wrong, people do occasionally smoke in the car and people do occasionally go over in miles, but this car has never been in a wreck. It's never been damaged. It is very much used to get from point A to point B, and as a result, people don't drive it a ton. And so because of all of these things, this car hasn't made as much money. Now, this is kind of a double-edged sword because all of these things are a pain to deal with, and whenever I don't have to deal with them, that is always a good thing, but it also means that there's less money to be made. And really the last reason is this is kind of an ugly car. I think that whenever you're looking at cars for Turo, even some older cars, it may not be really great. There's a cuteness aspect to some vehicles that can really go a long way whenever you're getting a renter. For example, I get a lot of compliments on my 2007 Toyota Yaris because of the fact that the car is cute looking. It's a cute looking car. My green Mazda does extremely well, and I think the reason why is because it's lime green. People like that. They think it's cool. But with my red Focus, it's red. It's like a maroon color. It's nothing cool. It has tan interior. The car in general is kind of ugly. It's just not a looker, and it looks very aged. So because of that, there just is really no silver lining to renting the car. The people that rent this car are renting it because they need a car to get from point A to point B. And that's a great reason to rent a vehicle, but there really is no extra benefit to this car that you sometimes will find with some of my other cheaper vehicles. Now, the question that you guys may be thinking is, why would I keep this car if it's an underperformer compared to all of my other cars? And the main reason is because it's consistently booked out. If this car was sitting at my lot day after day, not getting rented, I would definitely look at selling it. But this car is getting rented out, it is profitable, and because of that, I have no reason to sell it. But all in all, you guys, I wanted to make this video because I think it's really easy to talk about some of your best performers, and I think it's more difficult to talk about some of your worst performers. And I think it's important to shed some light on both sides of the spectrum. I'm happy with this Ford Focus, but it definitely isn't my top performer, and because of that, I probably will never buy another Ford Focus again, but I guess only time will tell. Like always, if you have any questions, comments, if you have anything to add, I would love to hear it, so make sure to leave a comment down below. And while you guys are at it, make sure to hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, and hit the notification bell, and I will see you guys in the next video.